Hello everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to get started with our Syncfusion Flutter charts. Today I am going to teach you how to add a simple Syncfusion Flutter chart into your Flutter application and add a column series to it and how to enable and access data labels and legend. Without moving further, I like to point out the supported platforms. Right now we support Android and iOS. For Android, we support the device types like phone, tablet, and the supported version is from API level 16 and later. For iOS, we support iPhone, iPod, and iPad, and supported version is from iOS 8 and later. The minimum Flutter SDK version that is required to render the Syncfusion Flutter chart is version 1.7.8, and you can always look into our help.syncfusion.com for any getting started documentation related chart. The entire chart package is available in pub.dev. Let's move on to the tutorial. I'm using the Visual Studio Code and I have already installed the Flutter and Dart extensions. So it is easy for me to create a Flutter application. Go to command palette, type in Flutter new project, name the project. Choose the folder where you want to place the application. Now, this will create a simple Hello World program for your Flutter application. As you can see, it will automatically download every required file and dependencies from the pub. Since the entire package of Syncfusion is available in pub.dev, go to pubspec.yaml file and declare the dependencies. The dependency is Syncfusion underscore Flutter underscore charts, and you have to name the version. Save it, and you can see that the package is getting downloaded from the pub.dev. Once the packages are downloaded, move to main.dart file. You can import the package. After importing the package, navigate to the home page. As you can see, there is a collection of widgets available here. I'm just going to remove this code. Since this is a Hello World program, I'm just removing the already available codes. I'm going to add a container. The container widget is used to set the height for the widgets. I'm going to set it as 550. And I'm going to place a child inside the container, which is the SF Cartesian chart. I'm just going to initialize the chart and I'm going to run this application. There you go. You can find a simple chart rendered here with X and Y axis, but we have not added any series to it. So let's add a chart series. To add a chart series, I need a data source. So I'm going to define a class called sales data. Inside the class, I'm going to declare a variable of type string, which is X. And another variable of type double, which is Y. And I'm going to declare a constructor called sales data, which initializes these two variables. Next, I'm going to define a method which returns the data source. Dynamic get column data. So I'm going to declare a list of type sales data. I'm going to name the list as column data. And I'm going to add data to it. So I'm just going to call the sales data constructor and initialize variables like now what I'm going to do is I'm going to return the column data. So now move on to the Cartesian chart. You have series API to add the series. This is of type chart series collection. So inside this collection, I'm going to add a column series as of type sales data. And it is of type string. I have to define the data source for the column series. So I'm going to get that data source from get column data method. And I have to map the two fields X and Y to the X value mapper. And Y value mapper. Next, I have to define the axis. Since we have given the X value as string, it is of type category axis. And I'm going to declare the primary y-axis, which is of double, so numerical axis. So I'm just going to save it. Since you have hot reload available in Flutter, so you can see the output then and there while you save the application. So there you go. You have a simple column series. Now let us see how to add data labels to it. Inside the series, you have to set the data label settings. Is visible to true. I'm going to save it. And you can see the data label is refreshed in the sample. If you want to place the data labels to the center of the column segment, then you can set the position to middle. I'm just going to save it. So there you go. You can see that the data label is now rendering at the middle of the column segment, and the data label color has been changed smartly based on the contrast background. Now let us make this chart more readable by providing title to the chart and adding title to the chart axis. Go to chart, add title. Title is of type chart title. Add the text. And inside the category axis, you can keep title, which is of type axis title. And inside y-axis, I'm going to provide another title. which is of access title, which is of type access title. I'm going to save it. So there you go. Now you have the title car sales, and you have the title for the X, and you have the title for the Y axis. Now let us add a legend to the chart. So I'm just going to enable the legend. It's visible property to true. I'm going to save it. You can see that it is rendering as a default series of type index 0. You can change that by providing name to the series. So I'm just going to provide a name. I'm going to save it. So there you go. Now you have a simple column chart with data labels, legends, axis titles, and chart title. Let me summarize what we have learned. We have learned how to add a simple column chart to the Flutter application and to enable the data labels. And we have learned how to add an axis and title for the axis. And we have also learned how to add legends. Thank you everyone for watching this video tutorial. If you like this tutorial, hit the like button. If you want more video tutorials, subscribe to our channel. Thank you once again.